Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Engineering Today. Let's begin our first update regarding SpaceX to fly SN15 within a week. SN15 high altitude flight will commence within a week. SpaceX will very soon carry out a full static fire of the newly installed engines. SpaceX had already announced certain local road closures with Cameron County for Thursday and Friday earlier, hinting that static fire could be carried out this week. According to some official documents filed with the Federal Communications Commission, SpaceX will conduct a test flight of SN15 on the 20th of April 2021. SN15 is expected to outweigh its predecessors, for it has certain upgrades and modifications. Elon Musk has also announced that the SN15 flight test will take place in the upcoming week. Installation procedure of new Raptor engines in the Starship is on the way. Musk had tweeted on the 15th of April 2021, aiming to launch next week. According to the filing, the Starlink receiver installed on the Starship SN15 prototype will provide high-speed internet access to the rocket from SpaceX's broadband satellite constellation. SpaceX has filed a request to the Federal Communications Commission to test a Starlink terminal around Boca Chica while in flight. The FCC request stated, SpaceX requests special temporary authority to operate a single-user terminal within 5 kilometers of Boca Chica Village, Texas, on an experimental basis at altitudes not to exceed 12.5 kilometers. The request also stated that the authority requested herein will be sharply limited in duration. SpaceX requests to operate under this STA for a period of only 60 days beginning on April 20, 2021. Or the date on which the STA requested herein is granted, whichever is later. These operations will only occur on the ground or during test flights of durations not to exceed 8 minutes. SpaceX is iterating that these test flights are all for improvements in their understanding and development of a fully reusable transportation system that can transport people and cargo all across the solar system. SpaceX has already announced that an orbital Starship flight will commence in July. The first commercial passengers are also booked for a trip around the moon in 2023. Now, unlike SN8, SN9, SN10, and SN11, SN15 has several upgrades in its design, so the test flight of this prototype is expected to be somewhat different, especially in landing. Let's move to our next news based on SpaceX placing a Dragon vehicle atop Falcon 9 for the Crew 2. SpaceX is now on the way of their second Crew Dragon mission, known as Crew 2. Earlier, SpaceX had launched their first Crew Dragon mission, Crew 1, of NASA's Commercial Crew Program on the 15th of November last year. The Crew 1 Crew Dragon will undock from the International Space Station after Crew 2 Dragon vehicle successfully carries out its docking maneuver with the space station. SpaceX has already placed their Crew Dragon vehicle atop the Falcon 9 rocket, scheduled for launching into orbit. SpaceX is reusing the same Falcon 9 booster, B-1061, for the Crew 2 mission, which they had earlier used for Crew 1 mission also. According to the 15th of April report, Crew 2 mission is just a week away from the planned launch date of the 22nd of April 2021. Report also says that the flight-proven Falcon 9 booster and a new expendable upper stage with the Dragon vehicle fixed atop will roll out to Launch Pad 39A very soon. A static fire test will also be carried out 4 to 5 days before launch. SpaceX is using the same Crew Dragon capsule for Crew 2 mission, which they had earlier used for the Demo 2 mission. After spending more than 2 months in orbit, this Crew Dragon capsule safely re-entered in Earth's atmosphere on the 2nd of August 2020 and splashed down in the Gulf of Mexico with both astronauts, Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken, safely. This reusing of the same vehicle is a great achievement for SpaceX in their refurbishment techniques. NASA's Kennedy Space Center tweeted on the 15th of April 2021, "Welcome back to Kennedy Space Center, Crew Dragon." SpaceX's Crew Dragon Endeavour made its way from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station to the Launch Complex 39A Integration Hangar this week in preparation for the Crew 2 mission launching on April 22nd. After Crew 1 became successful using a commercial vehicle, SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket and Crew Dragon spacecraft, NASA willingly gave permission to SpaceX to launch NASA astronauts on flight-proven booster and Crew Dragon vehicle. Several technical and organizational shortcomings have extensively delayed Boeing's Starliner crew capsule, so NASA has to rely solely on SpaceX for upcoming Crew Dragon missions, which are scheduled. Upon completion, Crew 2 will add on two more reusability feats in SpaceX's long history of significant reusability achievements. Let's talk about another SpaceX update in the next segment of our news. SpaceX keeps adding numbers to a fundraising round, as per the company officials announced earlier this year. According to an updated SEC document, SpaceX added another $300 million in a February round of funding. It's clear that with this funding, SpaceX will expand the work on its Starship launch system and Starlink satellite constellation. On Wednesday, April 14th, SpaceX revised its February filing with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission. According to SpaceX, February fundraising, which ended with the company raising a total of $850 million, now moved up to $1.164 billion. It's quite a big leap for SpaceX, as just a single round of company's funding brought in more than $1 billion. However, the company was not specific with the details for the additional $314 million. According to the filing, SpaceX investors jumped from 69 to 99 in the fundraising round. Last year, in August, SpaceX raised $1.9 billion, which is only one-third of its total funding today. SpaceX used most of the investment in developing the Starlink constellation, which now has more than 1,350 operational Starlink satellites in orbit. On the 14th of April, SpaceX's President and Chief Operating Officer, Gwynne Shotwell, participated in a conference held by the Massachusetts Institute of Technology's Department of Aeronautics and Astronautics. At the conference, she recalled her previous statements regarding SpaceX's Starlink broadband service. "With Starlink, we anticipate having full global connectivity, consistent global connectivity, a few months after our 28th launch," she stated. "We will continue to add capacity with additional satellites after that. We'll continue to improve our technology and basically get more beams on the ground." One of the major technology improvements is the incorporation of inter-satellite links, which SpaceX already tested in some of its satellites. "The first ones that we flew were very expensive. The second round of technology that we flew was less expensive," Shotwell stated, referring to the two generations of that technology. "In addition, a third generation of laser inter-satellite links are scheduled to start flying in the next few months. With the new technology, SpaceX will have the advantage over operating on long distances. Even though being less expensive than earlier versions, the new technology will provide high bandwidth." Another important project that Shotwell talked about at the conference is SpaceX's Starship development program. SpaceX is currently going with its latest Starship prototype, SN15. "Starship is an amazing machine. I could not be more excited about a vehicle than I am about Starship," she stated. "That is the vehicle that will take people in great numbers to the moon, to Mars." Shotwell also talked about in-Earth fast travel with Starships, a concept that SpaceX first discussed in 2017. "I believe we'll be flying large numbers of people on Starship in 5 years," she stated. While talking about sending people on Mars, she stated, "We're shooting for before 2030. It might end up taking that long, but I hope not. You're flying enough where you hopefully have enough knowledge of the system and knowledge of risk that you can definitely start the journey to Mars within the next 5 years," Shotwell stated. SpaceX will be developing its Starship for both in-Earth transportations and lunar missions. "I recognize we never make our timelines, so they're aspirational, but you have to aim high," she said during the conference. That's all for SpaceX. Now let's see what we have for others. A Canadian satellite operator, Telesat, made plans to raise $500 million in order to support its $5 billion light-speed broadband constellation. At the 2021 LEO Digital Forum, held on April 6, Telesat CEO Dan Goldberg stated that the company is expected to complete Lightspeed's financing in the next couple of months. "As Telesat Lightspeed manufacturing gets underway, we are committed to remaining good stewards of space. Our safety-by-design approach ensures our satellites are robust with individual component failures, allowing for continued operations," Telesat officials tweeted last month. Telesat is a well-known and one of the most successful global satellite operators. The company has plans to launch the constellation of nearly 300 satellites from 2022. The senior secured notes will provide the 60% cost of the project, while 40% will come through equity. The notes, due 2026, will be issued around April 27, 2021. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.